My name is Scott Rubin. I grew up in Chicago playing viola, doing martial arts, and then when I went to university, I started swing dancing, and so movement was always a part of my musical work. In 2014, I moved to Berkeley, California to start a PhD, and that's when I started performing and working with dancers and motion sensors and doing more interdisciplinary work. The new work I wrote for Gaudeamus is called For the Performers, written for three musicians from Catchpenny and some dancer friends, Yuri and Tatiana. So the work is for five performers with motion-sensitive live electronics and some video. From the beginning, I wanted to create a collaborative environment for the players to interact with each other in different ways. And for me, that's really hard to write down on paper because every time it'll be different. Because I live in Chicago and the performers live in Europe. And so I ended up sending samples of myself moving or of myself playing to the performers, and I would give them specific tasks. So improvise off of this or make a movement that is inspired by that. And so I would end up getting this library of sounds and of motions that I can analyze and draw the connections and create a network of relationships. So you have all these relationships. You can order them, you give them a structure. And you can create the electronics from the dancer's motions, just copying it in my bedroom and trying to see what kind of sounds I can get with samples from the performers themselves. So the piece is really for these five performers. It's not necessarily written for the audience. So the performers are sat in a way on stage where they're facing each other and they're not set up like a typical ensemble where everyone's facing the audience. So it's meant to be intimate. Do the performers even know that they're in a performance? Who are they playing for? Is it a ritual or a ceremony or some sort of occult gathering? And what are the rules behind this gathering? Is the audience included? Well, no, they're not. The audience is like watching fish in a fish tank. And do the fishes in the tank know that the audience is watching? Maybe they do, maybe they don't. One of the issues that I was having when first bringing together musicians and dancers is how do they talk to each other in performance and what sort of languages do they speak? How do they communicate? And so much of my work has been finding analog and digital solutions to facilitate this communication. So that can mean the musicians watching a dancer's body and interpreting it different ways on their instruments. It could mean dancers listening to the musicians and subverting their gestures or going along with it. But there's also a technological aspect of the piece where the dancers wear motion sensors on their arms, sometimes their feet. And this data goes into a computer, which also takes samples from the musicians and cuts them up in real time. So part of the electronics for the piece is you hear the musician's sound kind of married in a strange way with the movement of the dancers. So you have these electronic and analog connections between the performers. I don't have instructions for the audience with regards to listening, but more experiencing. We are in a room together, and you are experiencing this work with your eyes, with your ears, with the muscles in your body. Feel the bodies of the dancers. Try to perceive the relationships. Get inside the performer's head. The psychological states of the performers are very important to me. So what are they thinking when they're touching each other, when they're reacting to each other through various ways? It's not just music, but it's more of an experience.